Today, we are going to look how to store data with make no-code automations. Because in most cases, you are going to work with some sort of data in any place.
You're goddamn right.
And we are going to look into some general concepts, how you work with data, usually with make. And then also, we are going to look at different examples where you can store data with make. Hey, my name is Manuel and we love automation. Today we are going to look how to use databases with make no-code automation. So stay tuned for more. And if you haven't yet, please subscribe to our channel, turn on the notifications to not miss out any of the good content. Put in the comments below any topic that you might be interested in, and we are generating videos based on your requests. All right, let's get started right away. First, I want to show you like a very general concept of how usually you are working with databases. The first thing is that whenever something comes in and you want to update something in your database or want to create something new, you always have to search that database entry first, and then you decide whether it already exists and you can update it, or if it does not exist, then you want to create a new one. Compared to simply always creating a new one would result in a ton of duplicates, which you want to avoid in many cases. All right, now we want to search for voucher codes in this example, Google Sheet database. So we have users who are allowed to redeem in vouchers. So it's like an e-commerce example. We have a list of vouchers that we have over here with certain codes, and we want to make sure that every email, every person gets only one voucher and is not allowed to get another one later on. So how do we do this? First, we are going to use the search records module or search roles module for Google Sheet in order to match our income email and see if it already exists. So I'm going to start with a set role module to set the test email. And in that case, I'm using info@techflow.ai. All right, the next thing is I'm using Google Sheets search roles to check if it already exists in my database. So selecting from all, putting in the spreadsheet ID is usually the fastest way to find the sheet that you're looking for. I'm searching for the names, and then column C is containing the email address, so C, and then equal to our email. And usually I like to set it to case insensitive, because for email address, I don't care if the input of a form or something like that was uppercase or something, someone wrote something wrong in that email by using upper or lowercase. And I want to like avoid an error in that case and simply make it case insensitive. All right, I just want to get one result back if there's anything, because there should only be one email address anyways. It should be unique. And now we can let it run to see if it actually outputs any row. And we can see, okay, it outputs this first row. That means this already existed. And therefore, what we are going to do next is adding a router and with two different branches. The first one would be if this already exists, then we just want to update this. So we are using the update a row module. Can just map the sheet name and the row number from the previous one. We could also map the spreadsheet ID, but then it does not load the fields. Actually, with the sheet name, I will also select that. So it actually grabs the table headers, and then it's easier to use over here. So voucher code sent is already, should already be there. And then say, let's say we add another field, last requested timestamp, and then maybe a count of requests. Switch them around to make more sense. Okay, what I want to do here is I want to track how many times a user who already existed is requesting another voucher, just if I need it for analyzing purposes. And the way that I do it is using this one more time, just pressing OK, so it loads the new metadata. Okay, and then it refreshes the metadata, gets the new fields. Then I can open that one again, and I've refreshed the headers as well. And now I got the count of requests and the last request timestamp. So first, for the count of requests, it's column F, and then I will just use the sum function here and add one to it. So whenever the row is updated, it just counts up by one. Why am I using the sum function and not simply the plus? Because the sum function parses this as number already, and I don't have to use the parse number function, because if you hover over the count of requests, it shows it's text format and it's not a number format. I did another video on data types to exactly understand how you can work with all kinds of different data types. Now for the timestamp, let's just use the now timestamp and maybe just format date, and then use format date like this, and that's good to go. All right, let's see. We need to add a filter condition. So if something was found, usually I'll just use the row number. If the row number exists found, then I want to update this row. And it does not exist, so row number does not exist, not found, then I want to add a new row with the Google Sheet. Oops. Add a row. Row number does not exist, not found. And I'm using the same spreadsheet ID I did before. And insert the email address here. And for first name and last name, I don't have any variables here yet. But of course, you could have some here that you want to insert. For now, it does not matter. We're just going to use the email. Then for voucher code, this is actually something we have to look up first, because we want to get the next row that has no email address, but the voucher code is there. So we can use this one. So we could use the add row module here, configure it this way, and then add the email address and generate a random voucher code by just inputting, for example, the unique user ID, which generates a random value. And then you can like just substring it to the first few letters. So 0 to 6, for example. And first I want to replace any dashes with an empty string. So like this, because the unique user ID, it outputs dashes in between. And then if I remove them first and then get the first six characters, it basically gives me a random code. And then I also want to capitalize it to make it all uppercase. And that way it can generate a random string that you can use for anything, a random voucher code. And if you want to learn more about these vouchers, check out the link in the description below. We have a make functions cheat sheet that teaches you everything you need to know about make functions. They're super helpful and allow you to modify your data in a lot of ways, as you can see here. It's very easy to use and it's very helpful. So check them out. And then we also say voucher code send yes. And then the count of requests is one. And then I want to use the same timestamp as here with the date. So I just copy the formula from here and that's it. All right, good. So that is like the main concept of any kind of database. You always search for the record first, then you update it if it exists, and you create a new one if it does not exist. So how does it work now? If I run this and check our Google Sheet, it updated the info at TechFlow AI row, which is row number 3. It updated with a count of request and a last requested timestamp, because it already existed. So it found this record here and then it updated the row. So if I try it again, it should count it up. So now it's at 2, count of request 2. And now this will just keep counting up forever, every single time that I request it, and the timestamp will also be updated. If I now use a different email, so info plus test, for example, and then run this, it will actually add a new row here and it will edit down at the very end. It did not capitalize it, but it added all the other requests and it added at the end after all my data finished. So there's a hack how you can say, okay, I want to get the next voucher code that is not yet used, because oftentimes you have a predefined set of voucher codes and you want to distribute them. So you have to use the pre-existing ones and you can't generate your own one on the fly. So first let's fix the
uppercase one. It's not capitalized because capitalized is just the first letter. It's actually upper. So that was my mistake here. So let's remove that and try again. All right, now it's all uppercase and it generated a unique voucher code that I can use. Now let's check out the example where we can say, okay, if it's not found, then you want to use another module, which is the search rows module again, where we are searching the row, the first row that has a voucher code, but no email address. So let's insert the spreadsheet ID. Then the sheet name is name, and we want to search for the first voucher code that exists, and the email does not exist. So that basically gives us the first voucher that is not yet distributed. So, and then say yes, and we can say ascending by row number, and okay. And then we don't want to add a new row, because in that case the row already exists, but we want to update the existing one with the details. So let's update this module and simply use the row number of the new set rows module. Then we want to insert the email address that we have from our input data. We use the existing voucher code, which we don't have to update because it's already there. Then voucher code send yes, and the count can update that one. Here is nothing yet, so we can just set it to 1. And then the requested timestamp remains here like this. All right, now let's check our Google Sheet. So it should take the ABC 123 voucher code because, yeah, this is the first one that is not yet given out. Of course, we need to use a different email address. So it actually uses the update, or it actually does not find an existing record. And now searching, it will search the first empty row or first row that has only the voucher code but no email address set, and the row number is 5, and then it updates that specific row, and here we have our data set updated. All right, so that is how you generally work with data sets and data stores. You can apply that same concept to Airtable, to SmartSuite, to data stores within Make, and to any kind of database, basically. It always allows you to search an entry, then either update or create a new one, or if you want to have it a little bit more advanced, like you have predefined data sets already where you want to add data to, then you need to use another search rows and then update that specific row. All right, I hope this helped and you got value out of it and you have a better understanding how you work with data sets, and it really helps you. If you have any more questions about that, leave them in the comments below, and don't forget to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and turn on the notifications to stay up to date. Thank you very much for watching.